Hey everyone, this is Balint, and today I'm talking about one of ManyChat's newest features, which is smart delay. I realized many of my sequences were just one-time messages, little follow-up messages, and basically that's what smart delay is for. So it helps us have things more organized, keep it cleaner and simpler, because you can put it into the flow. You can just use it for here, or if you use the basic builder, you can add, let's do a continue another step, choose the next step, smart delay, okay? So it's very easy to put it into the same flow as you are, and it also doesn't need to be unsubscribed if you want to use it again. So with the sequences, you have to manage this in mind as well, okay? So what I'm going to do now is go over a couple of examples I have it, or I think it's cool, but let me know in the comments what do you use it for, and do you think it's what's the best use case for this, and we will build out a little sequence just in case. So what I think it's very good is to, if you want to reduce the information, you have, for example, you have two things to promote. You have A and B. Let's say A is a PDF or a video, and B is a Facebook group you want them to join. And in the onboarding, when you have new people, new clients, prospects coming to you, you don't want to overwhelm them with a lot of information and shove everything down their throats. What you want to do is to space it out a little bit. So what you can do is give them the PDF in your first message, then give them a couple of hours, and then provide them access to their Facebook group or whatever else you have. I literally mean follow-up messages with smart delays, like you send out a video and then you ask an hour later if the video is like 15 minutes long, like, hey, how did you like? What did you learn from it? How can I help? Blah, blah, blah. Or follow-up in a sense if they get stuck. So you have the ability to track what they do, what they type, what they click. And you know they clicked on something, but then didn't follow up and didn't get to the end of your, let's say, quiz or lead gen funnel. So you can pop in a couple of minutes later and say, I saw you got stuck. What's going on? How can I help you? Or you know the issue. Maybe it's an email. You want to ask them for their email address, and they don't give their email address. And you say like, hey, we take data seriously. It's because blah, blah, blah. And I don't say you will convert everyone, but you can kind of address the issue or learn more about them. So it's pretty clever. And that's why I love chatbots as well. And the fourth option could be offering them a manual reminder. So let's say you send out a video and the video is 50 minutes long and they probably won't have the time at the time of getting this message. So what you can offer them, like you have a button like, yeah, watch the video right now. And another button would be, I'm busy right now. So if they click on I'm busy right now, we can offer them a delay, a smart delay, and say, oh, no worries, I will get back to you in 1 hour or in a day. Choose one of them options, and they can manually choose, and then you redirect them to the same flow again, okay? So let's take a look at this. So let's say we want to get a message, and we say, let's just go with first name, and let's keep it casual. It's Messenger after all. Hey, I have a great video about the new function. Check it out below. Don't quote on me on this copy, but I just want to do like watch video now. Open a website. Let's go with YouTube. Okay, and what I want to add is another button, remind me later. Okay, all right, I'm busy now. So they probably think they will get away with not doing anything there. But what we will do here is add another message. Oh, no problem. Oh, yeah. Aren't we all? I can remind you in. And then what we can do here is like have like a 30 minutes. And let's say tomorrow. Okay. So it's very easy. And after that, what we do is just add the small delay. So what we can do here, 30 minutes, and we set the timer 30 minutes. We don't need to delimit this. And we say, So here's the video again. Let me know what you think. Let me know how you like it. But that's okay. I just keep it simple. It's not copywriting now, and watch the video. I actually could have copied it from the other one. Now coming to think about it. But that's okay. Okay. And what we want to do here is set up another delay. So let me just copy this one. I cannot copy this. Whatever. I just create a new one. And I will set it one day. I probably will limit the time. I usually suggest limit the time when it's like 4 hours or a couple of hours, because it's probably that they look at it in the evening. It's probably not that they look at like 3 a.m. one day and the next day they want to go to sleep after 11, but it can happen. I'm a little bit liberal on this, but I had people message me like, oh, I was looking at it the first day at very late, but I usually don't stay up that late. And you can reuse this message as well. So that's pretty cool. All right. So I figured it would be taking so much time to set up everything. So I created it and I will just comment it. So what we want to do now is create two extra follow-up messages. One is when they watched the video, and one if they didn't click any of these options. So the first one, if they watched the video, we assume they watched, when they clicked on the watch the video button. So I created a tag, watch the video, and I added to both options here. So another thing for the reminder is I have a tag here, requested reminder, and I take away this tag after the reminder is done, which is when they got to this message. Okay, so that way I can filter if they have a reminder waiting for them or not. So you don't want to message them again if they said they are busy and they want to wait till tomorrow. Okay, so what happens here is that I have a 2 hours timer here, and I only continue after 2 hours here. So after the 2 hours, I check if they clicked on the button. If they clicked, then I say, hey, what was your main takeaway from the video? Whatever, you can build it out fairly well here. You can have a follow-up system, pitching something according to their answers, whatever. And if that's not the case, then I check if they requested the timer or not. And if they didn't request the timer, so they didn't click on that button, or the timer already expired and we are after here, because I link back to here, then I just ask them an alternative, or give them an alternative, split the information. If you prefer, I have the PDF summary here, or by the way, I have the Facebook group, or whatever you want to say. And for those who don't match here the requirements, for them, you just have to set up something. It can be an empty message, a tag they already have. For example, the click the. You can just play with, like, I have like a empty dummy variable here called dir. So yeah, that's about it. And there is a more advanced way to set up here the timer with the follow-up message. And we will cover that tomorrow in the rules. As always, let me know what did you learn. And if anything's unclear, just let me know. And what you want me to do the next video on. I'm really stoked about this challenge. Talk to you tomorrow.